Today's run was suggested by Finey. If you'd like to choose a run, leave a comment down below with a character, a blessing of choice, and a main weapon. Hey, Chapel here, and today we're doing another episode of Choose the Run on Reincarnation 8. And today's one is the dog with one dog army and the porcupine. So let's get started. So it'll end up being a run where we're dual wielding a lot less than usual, and right from the get-go we already have health recovery, which is pretty broken. This ascension is really, really good early game, and I mean, it's not ascension, blessing, sorry. It's good early game, and it's still incredibly strong, the buff, in the late game. It's not quite as useful as it is at the start, but still a big deal. Is it 150%? Yeah, 150% for weapon and skill damage. And it does combo very well with the atomic bomb build, but since during this we're only going to be taking one blessing, there will be no atomic bomb this run. And there's capacity overdraft with our first scroll, so we are more than happy to just spam nades now. And we'll take that as our second weapon. We have a miasma already if needed. Okay, and golden comeback, certainly not, because it's not going to be a run of dual wielding much. Adrenaline rush early on. Perfect. We will take that. Even more health regen and some more damage reduction. Pretty good. Got another vault here. We've got that self-damage from the capacity overdraft, but doesn't matter too much when we've got so much of the health regen already. And then elemental weave, that's interesting. So now it makes a lot of sense to just be weaving between the thunderstorm and the porcupine. Curse scroll, why not? Oh, and we got a jewel edge from it. Wow, this is going to be a lot of damage. Miasma online already, and the elemental weave, it completely negates the elemental curse right now, because we're guaranteed the effects anyway. So, until we get that removed though, it kind of takes out the option of an elemental Gemini, which makes a lot of sense with the porcupine. So we might end up just having to be using the elemental weave until that's dealt with. But right now this is a lot of damage we've got. It's only going to get better with the dual edge. This is quite an annoying event. It persists for the whole room as well. That's fun. Oh, this one's got an awful one too. Enhanced Lightning Enthusiast. I think the text on this is wrong still. Apparently, I think it's meant to be for Lightning Enthusiasts, that you don't actually get the negative part of it, it or something. Like the text needs to be updated on that to make it more clear about what actually was. But regardless, it's not a brilliant enhanced scroll to get there. At least it does something, since I'm using a lightning weapon right now. But very early revive gun. Oops. It's fine. Yeah, I just really didn't dodge enough there. I just got hit by one of the fireballs. I was too focused on trying to deal with the traps. Nope. I'll take the explosion enhancement. Just get some extra AoE on the grenades. Feel that. Ooh. Goodbye, shields. Pin both these. There we go. Against the flow, evil devouring sword, or advanced joggers. We have got our first curse scroll. I'm tempted to just take this right now. The advanced joggers were good too, but getting to flow also wasn't bad, but I don't think I care about no reload too much with a porcupine. Oh, that's a car. Yeah, it's just immediate full stacks of miasma in doing this. Oh, okay. A sealed defense room should be able to do enough damage to this pretty easily. Like, I've got so many damage boosts right now. Just clear with grenades. Ooh. One's targeting at me. That's rude. There we go. Mm. Oh, we got rich privileges. It's between that and brief respite. Because obviously we're doing so many weapon swaps. I'm gonna just take the rich privileges right now. Because if I just use elemental weave for my damage as well, I don't really need to do weapon upgrades because they're doing all my asthma. Doesn't really scale well with weapon upgrades, so just having the extra skill damage with rich privileges is a big deal. Resolute. I'm tempted. Yeah. I certainly wouldn't say no to a flesh and bones now that we got that. And evil banishing. Nice. Good, good, good. So no more elemental curse for us. We have normal speed as well. That does nothing if I do find the flesh and bones though. Close call, I like getting a point in right now too. Vindictive nature. Oh, and that's a very good lightning weapon to Ellie weave with. Yeah, I'll take that. And short devils. Oh, I don't think I want that. That's making us a bit too glass cannon. I'll drop that. Yeah, I'm just gonna get one hit if I use that. Alright, and this should be a really fast boss. Full stack my asthma. Oh, I need to remember to actually. Spirit feline? Oh, that's not bad either. A flowing light. I do not want that. Overloading or sustain fire? I think that's a sustain fire there. Okay. And I'm not allowed a second blessing here. I have to stick with the one dog arm. Rules are rules. Just got lightning on me. Oh my god, I missed so many shots there, that's embarrassing. Finding a way to avoid reloads on the porcupine would be nice. I did actually have that option earlier. Maybe I should have taken against the flow. What was the alternative I took? I don't remember. Oh, is the evil bowing sword I think I took. Check out what's in their vault. Yeah, there is. And scrap this as well. So yeah, I'm not doing any of the weapon upgrades right now. I could easily find a better porcupine. I'm using rich privileges. And I'm doing my asthma damage. Which means I don't care about weapon damage scaling too much anyway. Because my asthma only cares about how fast your on-hits are to apply it as quick as possible. Yeah. one shot port fire, and it's fully stacked by our spot. There we go. Magic Watch does nothing really. It resets the dash, but the other two do nothing at all, so second point in close call here is the plate. Bullet bank, no retreat, or let's roll the... Oh no! Oh, that's not good. Oh, that's not good at all. I'm gonna be greedy. I'll try keep hold of the Resolute. The important thing is getting rid of Paranormality ASAP. Okay, let's take that. Yeah, this is going to be very scary in the meantime. I'm not really allowed to get hit. That has completely ruined, like, any defense I have. But hey, the veteran is good. Of course, I wasted my revive in Act 1, so if I lose, then, or if I die, that's the run over. Uh-oh. Just want one where I can give a scroll away. Come on. Well, I guess I may as well take the close call. It's lost all its value after picking up the Paranormality though, so... Wait. Can he bail me out? What have you got? Oh, I've not seen this one. Oh, okay. Well, I'm not using automatic weapons, but sure, let's pick it up. On the bright side, like, I kill stuff so fast that I am able to just kill everything untouched as long as I don't get in range. Damn, that's a pretty good Angelic Aura there. Had plus projectiles on and such. Yeah. Nice. Has a good scalpel as well, as a plus projectiles on that too. Oh no. All these good weapons in normal circumstances that I could have taken, but I've got to be using the porcupine. This this could help bail me out as well in the meantime, until I find a way to remove this. Sure. Nah, I think I can do better than that. Okay, no. Now I, like, truly just get one hit if I'm hit by anything. I've got the, like, thing that's a couple lifeguarding, is it? The talent. So that can save me from one hit, but after that. Oh, a demon lord. Oh no. Oh, I messed up my movement. I didn't mean to dash that way. There we go. Okay. Where's the red chest? Surely there's... Okay. No! No, it only lets me destroy a curse scroll. It is my curse scroll. Paranormality is worse than a curse. Okay, I survived one hit. Extra AoE size, I think I'll take again. Like, the damage is being carried by Jewel Edge and One Dog Army, so I think I can just take the... I mean, the AoE gives more damage as well, of course, but it's not quite as much. But the, yeah, extra AoE size doesn't. Oh, wait. Depleted my shield. Okay, there's a couple more grenades. Ooh. I gotta play this so carefully right now. It is annoying. Even the star power is just doing a lot of fucking damage. Was that my one-shot protection from there? I feel like it must have been, right? There's no way I survive a shot from one of these. 55 health. Where's the... Oh, there he is. Okay. Numerous elites. They're both henchmen. Okay, nice. Oh, wait, I thought that was an explosive gun. Fire damage thunder, that's cool. Spirit Bible, okay, good. dual wield, max HP, all three of those don't do anything. I could run an explosive. Oh wait, I was on autopilot. I kind of wanted to take that. Because yeah, I could have done an explosive elemental weave instead, but oh shit. Oh, that's about to die. Okay, that one goes to rapid fire. Oh my god, yeah, one shot. Yeah, that's why I wanted to try and take out the rapid fire ones first, so he didn't kill me. Look around for a red chest again. There's sometimes one up here. Nope. One here. Nope. One back there. And nope. Ah. Okay, this is sometimes a tricky room. So yeah, gotta place. Oh, it's only yeah, these things are bigger threats than just single shots. Oh my god, what do I get hit by? What was I hit by? Is there a fiery enemy? Oh my god. Oh, I'm dead. Yeah, next shot is a death. That's both my revives gone and should have come back. I really want to just try and get to this scroll now. This vault now. Oh, it's an elite one though. I thought it was a chest one from a distance. Heavy shield like helps a bit. I've got an okay amount of more speed, so I should be fine sort of moving out of stuff. Get rid of that. And I'm not reloading often, so I just take more explosive damage for the grenades. A fire illusion. Nope. Nah, none of those. I'll just stick with these two. I'll just run my asthma still. Asthma's pretty damn good against Windigod. Focus on not getting hit as much as possible. Oh wow, he's in my lead transition. Okay. Yo! Oh, the run saved. The spirit feline. Oh, God. Okay. That makes things a lot less scary. This is the only thing that does anything. I still want to try and get this paranormal malady removed ASAP. Because there's still no shield regen at all. For this build. So yeah, main things right now, like we've got a stacked dual edge with feline. So just getting paranormality out and then maybe getting a new porcupine that I can start upgrading, and then I'll swap out of my asthma and go into like combustion instead. Then the run will be looking pretty good. But yeah, that's made things a lot less stressful. There's still a lot of enemies that can kill me right now, though. I still can't play stupid, because anything like if I get the fire effect on me, that kind of thing, then it could still be bad. And that's a much better porcupine. There we go. This one's good enough to be upgrading. So yeah, we will put a damage share on this and try and share it with a fire tower or something. Hello. Yeah, wait, this guy's scary. I don't want anything to do with him. Oh, wait. I'm up there. Oh, heavy shield saves me, actually, versus this guy. He does more damage. Yeah, it's, it's not fun having feline against him. Okay, no. If that had damage share on it, then I might have taken it. Brief respite. Yep. I like that. Since I've got rich privilege, I'm still in no rush to be weapon upgrading, especially since I'm still doing elemental league. Oh, okay. That's chill. Sure. It's close whether this thing's better or not. I'll try out this one. It's actually got the Gemini. Okay, red chest. Nope. And I can't drop the paranormality, so I can't even grab that. I mean, not that it matters actually, I've got the spirit feeling, I forget, so. Regardless of getting more max health or whatever, it doesn't mean anything really. Wait for him to explode. There we go. Yeah, so far it's been 2 out of 2 of these choose the runs where I've just magically got an early jewel edge. So, and I mean this time it's even higher roll because I got the spirit feline with the jewel edge. I mean the paranormality thing certainly wasn't a high roll, but hey, with how the runs changed to now, like, I'll take it. It doesn't really matter about that anymore too much. Like I say, it does give me a lot more security if I do get rid of it, but I still have to mess up to die right now. Because I've got the, like, one-shot protection, I've just not got the regen. So the things that kill me are just TP monks, or the penguins in Act 4, just any of those kind of things. Aside from that, like, I don't really have an excuse for dying right now. Check him. Enhance. Oh, wait. Okay. So, I'm pretty sure the burning doesn't... If it does, then... Actually, I don't apply burning right now anyway, so it doesn't matter. For the meantime. But yeah, there's a chance that burning on myself could just kill me, so I will have to drop it until the paranormality goes, if that is the case. Oh. Yep, sharks are a joke for my asthma. Good. Regen he had though. Nah, I don't care about that. Nope. Another elite fight. Oh, I need to get rid of these. They are a much bigger threat than the elite. There we go. Okay, that does nothing. I like the strategic advantage. More new speed once again. Oh, free of that. Let's go. Okay, there are a lot of annihilation monks here, so just gotta be wary of those on this stage. Yeah, brief respite will do a lot of work for keeping you alive, don't you? Like that. And a heavy shield. Oh no, oh that's not good. Okay, these things all have to die ASAP. Not fun. Gonna be a few more up ahead. It's a pretty long room to be getting this event on, but if I didn't have brief respite or heavy shield, then this is a pretty doomed room, to be honest. Or if I didn't have the damage to just one shot them like this. There we go. Like, look at that. One grenade just nuked them all. ...443 jewel edge stacks now. Get rid of the annihilation monks first. Ah. That's going to be even more. Oh, I didn't even mean to kill that monk there, he just jumped at me. Another plus projectile scalpel. And grenade blaster, cool. That is good. The other two really sucked, but... And I don't think there's a red chest again, sadly. But we do get a chest vault for once, a parkour vault. I don't think I've had any yet this round, so... And do the little trip jump. Corrosive Shard, Copper Miner, Berserk Soul. I've not got slow immune, so may as well take this. And plus I do actually... Oh my god. That's rubbish. I am of course using a corrosive weapon as well, so we are getting a bit of damage boost from that. Sure. Won't trigger burning effect. Oh, there's a... Oh, I want it so bad. No. Why do I have to be cursed by the paranormality? I want my flesh and bones. Oh, ha. If I was more boozy, I could have just taken the flesh and bones anyway. I've got enough knee speed to really not get hit by something bad. I nearly jinxed that way, I was close to not doing that. Luckily, I think I have my respite active at the time, but I got hit by so many blades. If I didn't have so much of an ability to look down, that would have been my death. Realm of Corrosion, okay. And dual wielding. It does nothing. I may as well take the one pointer because it takes it out the pool, but of course it does nothing right now. Great. So, same plan still. Get rid of the... Oh no, wait. Oh, I don't like the fact that they have damage immunity. Get them out. That's a new star devourer. Nah, I don't think it's him. Though it's just got the extra weapon damage from the star devourer on me as well, takes that thing. Probably a little better than the one I had, but didn't have very good inscriptions. Check Mr. Peddler. Nope. There we go. No red chest. Oh, don't look like it. Get him off me. There we go. Yeah, this it's kind of just the miasma and the dual edge, but this is gonna end up clocking in at like under an hour long run if I end up winning it. It's not been a long one at all. chaser. I think. Didn't get that one. Oh, this is slow. Yeah, yeah. Because the clones take less damage as well. He's not dying quite as quickly. Nice. Although, elemental power, or because that's too late, it's between premium membership and elemental power. Because I think, like, I do want to sort of swap the Gemini on this and such still, but I think for now the elemental power is just so much better. Getting the like cleave on elemental effect is really, really powerful. Nice that my asthma actually kills those things again. That's all I'll say. Wait, oh, I was gonna say, why is he not dead yet? One more area can we remove Harold Malty by the that's the question. Fire on me. Nope. Oh. To actually re-roll this back to being fire. There we go. Yeah, I can't do damage if the event is removing my ability to inflict corrosive or lightning. Oh no! Okay, get them. That's not the enemy that I want to be ignoring. He is far too scary for that. Oh wait, I'm unable to inflict a cake. No. Swap to fire, please. Please. Oh my god. It rolled onto corrosive so many times there. At least the cavalry didn't actually charge at me during that time. Oh, I think. There we go, finally. Yay! Another ascension that does nothing. The red chest! Please! And wait. Oh. Nope.
Nah, it's sticking around.
It's sticking around till the end. ...639-stack jewel edge. With Spirit Feline, you would be taking 120% extra damage. Fast loader, very nice. Dormant Bullet's okay, I think. And hey, screw weapon upgrade still. I just want rich privileges. Oh, I'm bad. Go ahead, bye bye. Crazy thought. My asthma doesn't do very well on the DPS. Yeah, that is the one trouble with my asthma. It deletes everything. Now even UFOs, now that they've changed it back to it doing normal damage on those. But last boss, DPS phase, not a chance. It barely does anything to this boss. And of course on Serpent, the end of Act 3, barely does anything there too. But yeah, hope you guys enjoyed a 52 minute run this time. Another sub hour, another lucky early jewel edge, incredibly stacked. Pretty funny with the paranormality from the chest there. And yeah, just abusing Elemental Weave for pretty much the whole run. Just mediocre Porcupine, non-upgraded. Mediocre Star Devourer, just random one from Act 4. And yeah, just all the damage being carried by like Jewel Edge, Rich Privileges, and the Elemental Weave. Where's the Elemental Weave at? There it is. Defense being carried by Spirit Feline, Heavy Shield. Where's the Brief Respite? Yeah, there, Brief Respite. And Paranormality, of course, carrying defense. And, oh, Spirit Bible was decent too. Those are the main ones. Like, the weapon damage stuff didn't matter too much because I stuck with the Miasma till the end, so the elemental damage matters a lot more than the weapon damage. But yeah, anyway, hope you guys have a good day. I'll see ya.